Yeah, baby, yeah. E3 2019, we back at it again. It's the one and only hip hop game, I Hot 97. Logitech G, you see me, baby. You already know what it is, baby. That's how you do it. Alright, on the count of three, we gonna say Watch Dogs again. Y'all ready? Alright, 1, 2, 3, Watch Dogs! Watch Dogs Legion, baby! That's what I'm talking about. First off, before we even do the interview, I gotta give you a hug, man. Seriously. So, I need y'all to understand something. I never seen a game accomplish the things that I thought was possible because I never seen it before. So we're gonna break it all the way down, all right? The first thing is this. I never seen a game where the NPCs, which is non-playable characters, can be playable characters. How in the world, how many late nights you stood up, how many times like your wife got mad at you or something that allowed, that made that reality? I never seen that before. Talk to me.
There's a lot of people who've worked really, really hard, engineers, artists, narrative designers, writers, animators, who did put in a lot of hard work to really make all of those pieces come together. It's been a long journey and a wild ride.
Now, how does that change the story and the gameplay, considering you got all these different personalities and also different abilities between all the NPCs?
Well, absolutely, for sure. Every NPC in the world doesn't just have a name and a job. They have also friends and family and a place where they live and hobbies and activities and all that stuff. They also have a trait that's reflected in their backstory. Let's say someone was an Olympic target pistol shooter or something. That guy's gonna have a better pistol skill. And then you recruit that guy into your team and you can give him a class, you can make him an enforcer or an infiltrator, and then he's gonna get perks and other abilities that unlock over time. And so that's the gameplay side.
Yeah. Oh my God. Now look, normally I give people the belt when they like blow me away, but it'll be an honor for you to wear the chain, please. We gotta put the chain on Clint, son. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Get that joint to spin, baby. Get that joint to spin, baby. Yo, we lit. So look, now, the next question I got for you, the story. Now, how does like the non-playable, because when I saw it, they was talking about there's so many different storylines and how it play out. How does that work in terms of like who you end up with? Like, how does that work in terms of story?
So any character that you recruit from the open world, they're gonna have different animations, they're gonna have different voices, they have a completely different script. And so when you go into a cutscene with a 70-year-old grandma.
With a grandma, yeah.
Go into a cutscene with a grandma, she's gonna perform differently, she's gonna say lines differently, the scene's gonna play out differently than if you go in with a athletic 20-something.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. So now I got a major question for you. Okay. So because you can recruit people and create your own team, what does this mean or what can you talk about in terms of online play, co-op, and all of that? Because in my mind, I'm like, just to let you know, I'm an NPC in Watch Dogs 2. I'm actually in that game.
Yeah.
I would love to be in Watch Dogs Legion as well, but how does that work in terms of your team co-op?
So we're not talking a lot about online, but
okay,
you will be able to go online with up to 4 players, 3 of your friends, bring your whole team, and they bring their whole team, and you can swap between all your characters just like you do, and play missions with them, and do online activities with them, and all that stuff. We're gonna talk a lot more about that after E3, but you will be able to have that experience you had with your team and your friends.
Oh my God! So now, I wanna commend y'all on something. The driving is great.
Like it?
The driving is great, because I know it's hard to get driving done in like a game like this. So the driving,
they're driving on the wrong side of the road, right?
Of course, yeah, that threw me off out the gate. I was like, yo, wait, hold, why am I running in there? And then I got it. I was like, okay, cool, gotta be on the other side. So now, here's what I want to tell you. When it comes to the driving and the actual combat, the fact that y'all actually got real fighting, not just takedowns.
Yep.
So when it comes to the combat, over time, does it get better? Like, do y'all have a skill point system to make the combat better?
So again, different characters have different traits. So if someone studies kung fu, he's gonna have maybe do more damage or take less damage. Or there are a couple of different fighting styles in the game. There's just the generic fighting style, which is like the way some guy like me fights. There's like the trained fighting style for people who know how to do like spin kicks and stuff like that.
Yeah.
There's a few different fighting styles in the game.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, of course there's perks as well. So if you is particularly if you're an infiltrator class,
yeah,
you have some perks that affect their that make their melee better.
Now I'm gonna tell you something. Because the fans need to know this. We've seen a lot of games so far at E3, from Cyberpunk to what they showed at Halo with Scarlet, Doom Eternal, and I love those games as well. But I want to commend you and the entire team over at Ubisoft. I'm going to tell you why. I never seen one game pull so much from like what you've seen in other games dynamically and do it correctly. I never seen it before in my life. Therefore, I think this is the best game at E3 and a game to represent the generation of gaming going forward. So I just wanted to clap it up for you real quick, son. Real talk. Just want to clap it up. Real talk. So I got two more questions. And we're going to let it go. I got two more questions for you. So now my next question is this. Watch Dogs Legions is not called Watch Dogs 3. So is this like a setup to something even bigger, or y'all just done away with the numbers?
We're not talking about what might come next, but I think we really wanted to have a title that reflected thematically what the game is about. You don't just play as three people. Watch Dogs Legion, you play as anyone.
Okay, cool. Now, I gotta ask you this. When it comes to Watch Dogs overall, the moment I saw this, something that I thought about Watch Dogs in real life. So I'm gonna give you an example of what I mean, because with next generation technology, we're looking at a parallel between what you can do in real life and how what you do in real life can affect the game. So my question to you, let's say you buy a Watch Dogs Legion shirt, or let's say there's a place in London that somebody go to and activate something, and in return you get experience points in your game by doing something in real life. Have you thought about having something, whether it's an app or whatever, where we could walk around in real life with our phones and do something that can affect the game?
I have not thought about that, but you should be a game designer, my man.
That's Oh my God! That's an amazing compliment coming from you. So look, on a count of three, let's just say Watch Dogs. You ready? All right. 1, 2, 3! Watch Dogs! Legion! When is it coming out?
March 6, 2020.
Let's go, baby! On that note, we out of here! Let's go!
Ah! I love you, man.
Thank you. This is amazing. Thank you.
God bless y'all. Well, I gotta get a crew. I gotta give it the crew. On count three, come back in. We gotta get the crew in. All right, cool. My man got the chain on and everything. Everybody come on in. We about to do this right. All right, on the count of three, we gonna say Watch Dogs again. Y'all ready? One, 2, 3, Watch Dogs! That's how you do it. We out of here, baby. Peace.